and disturbed something. Whatever it was, it got out into the air and into the minds of his family.
Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat. Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real. That's what people respond to. Reality.
What do the dead have to say? You'd be surprised by how little they know. The dead can't explain what it means to be dead. They walk down stairs that disappear beneath their feet, headed for some bright blade of memory they'll never reach.
He probably ran. But why wouldn't he? Why would he be here? Shit. That was probably a raccoon.
No. No, I don't think it was.
He's just a kid. He didn't disturb anything. He just found a room in an old house. That's it!
Oh, boy, is the price. I'm going up there. The sleeper must not sleep. He can't get away. It's the sleeper's time to awake.
Missy, listen to yourself.
No. I see clearly. The sleeper breathes inside me.
You're sick. We all are.
Dale, what are you doing?
Something.
Dale, you miserable coward! Let me out! The sleeper demands to rise! The sleeper must wake up! The sleeper must wake up! The sleeper must...
Mom, I thought I heard her voice.
She's, still looking for you. You need to leave. Go through there.
Through that water? It kind of looks like it's boiling.
No, it's just a simple chemical reaction. It's not actually boiling.
Mom! Mom! Where are you?
I'll deal with your brother. Just go, now.
Who she once was. Neither was he. Something was using all this pain and death. Something was becoming stronger.
Ethan, I told you to stay out. God damn it. Look, it's dangerous in here. I'll read your story later. Okay? And, please don't tell your mother I'm in here. All right? Okay, now you go. Get back home.
I could feel two kinds of darkness here in Red Creek Valley. The first you walked into, and with any luck, walked out of. But the other darkness was deeper, stickier, unknowable. And it wanted me to leave.
Where's my mother? Why are you standing in the sleeper's way?
She had an accident. Travis, put down the axe.
An accident.
I didn't want her to get hurt. We're all so sick, you know? Since Ethan found that room.
Where's Ethan, goddammit? Talk to me!
Okay! He wants to burn Vandegrift's room. Look, Travis, just leave me alone! Oh, God. Oh, God!
The sleeper chooses vessels. You know that? To enact his wishes, he chose Mom. He chose me.
Son, I don't want to hurt you.
You think scissors are gonna save you?
Yes.
It didn't have to be this way. You could have helped the sleeper, helped us. But Mom's right. You're a coward, and you'll be meeting Ethan again soon.
Travis, we can get rid of it. I know exactly what we're up against. Don't listen to what's in your head.
This sleeper was feeding. Ethan's father figured suicide wouldn't feed it. But it did. I could feel it sitting somewhere out there, fat as a bullfrog, digesting. Thank you. was close. I could feel him. A pinprick of light in the darkness. He would know me. He would know why I'd come.
Then fight it! I have to destroy the room!
Corvus, I'm sorry. Ethan, I can't let you do that.
Ethan, I fought it off. It's okay.
Grandpa, get away from me!
Your grandmother Gail is protecting me from it. Ethan, I can help you.
I found Vandergrift's diary. He said for the sleeper to wake up, someone has to suffer. Look! When I found that room, I didn't wake him up. He's trying to wake up now. Vandergrift kept his victims alive. He made them suffer. That's what the sleeper wants.
We need to get in that room.
I can squeeze through.
Gail, It has to be this way. The sleeper must not wake. Burning the room won't matter, Ethan. The sleeper's inside us now.
Grandpa! Get back!
We all have to die. Even you. Even me.
You stopped it. It was horrible, but you stopped it.
Paul Prospero? Are you really here?
I'm sorry, Ethan. I was late. Too late.
You're right. You were too late.
Here. Again. Not yet.
Christ, Ethan, you're in here again? You missed dinner. Mom and Dad are pissed. They've been looking all over the place.
Get out of here, Travis. Leave me alone.
Hey, Ma, he's in here. Honey, be careful with that lamp.
Dale. The hell's wrong with your kid? Painting on walls, writing his stories. I mean, what the fuck?
Ethan! For God's sake, you missed dinner!
I'm sorry. I've been working on a story all day. How long have I been out here?
The Adventures of Paul Prospero, Supernatural Detective. Where do you get this stuff?
Pop, would you get Travis out of here, please?
He draws pictures on walls. What the hell is that?
Chad! Shut up!
You got yourself a faggot for a son, Dale.
Travis, let's go. Come on.
Faggot! Ethan, you're a fucking faggot!
Travis, stop it!
Oh, shit! Shit!
Everyone! Go! Get out!
Get out! The smoke, it's toxic!
Oh, Jesus!
Oh, God!
What do we do? What do we do?
I wrote about you, but I don't know if I created you.
You made me real.
I can't go yet. I have to finish my story about you. I wrote stories about everyone.
I know you did, but my story's done, and it's a fine story.
I can let go?
You can let go.
What happens then?
Another story, kid. What else?